She can say in her voice, in her way, that she love me. With her eyes, with her smile, with her belt, with her hands, with her money.
Hey y'all, welcome back. So this video we're going to talk about this lady right here, my godmom. Well, this is me, this is my godmom. I'm gonna talk about her. She just released her new book, Releasing Her. It is a book about her mother, who passed from Alzheimer's, and she talks about her experience taking care of her mom, like her and her sister's experience taking care of her mom, and just giving some little signs of what you should notice in a person who may have Alzheimer's disease. It's a really good book. You can get it off of Amazon for $14.95, $16 with tax, and it's also a part of Amazon Prime, so you will get it very fast. It's an amazing read, and I promise you, once you pick the book up and start reading, you're not going to want to put it down. And I'm not just saying this because she's my godmom. Like, it's really a good read. And so I'm going to dedicate this painting to her mom. And I'm excited about this painting. And let me just say, I didn't know her mom that long. Before the times I did know her, she was an amazing woman. She was so awesome. And my most memorable memory was when one day, I was thinking they were either picking me up for church or dropping me off. I think they were picking me up. But anyway, Sundays I would go to church with my godmom. And so she would sometimes, I think it was like only at maybe once or twice, where she would pick me up first and then she'll go get her mom ready and then we'll go to the church. Or her mom will already be ready and she'll be in the car and she'll come pick me up. But anyway, this particular time, my Nana wound up coming downstairs with me, and my Nana never came downstairs when it was time for me to go to church. She always stayed upstairs, but this time she came downstairs. And when she came downstairs, she saw my godmom's mom in the car, and she opened the door. Now, my Nana did not know that her mom had Alzheimer's. And so my Nana opened the door and she said, Imogene Watkins, is that you? And I was in shock. So I'm like, how do you know her? And her mom was like, Betty Thompson. And she was like, yes. And my Nana gave her a huge hug and they started talking, started chatting. And I was just like, wow, it is a small world. And it comes to find out is that my Nana and my godmom's mom worked together. And I was just like, wow, that's so interesting. And that was, it was interesting to see, like, even though she had Alzheimer's, she still remembered certain things. And it was another memory that I had from what my godmom told me, because, you know, it was routine for me to be picked up. And one particular time I didn't go to church that Sunday, and she asked my godmom, are we going to pick up the little girl today? And I was the little girl. And my godmom was like, she remembers you. And that was very, that touched my heart. And so I'm just excited to do this painting. I hope that I do it justice. The photo that I chose for this painting is coming out of the obituary, and the obituary has a whole bunch of photos. Like, it's 4 pages full of photos, but the photo that I chose is this one right here. I don't know why I chose that one, but out of all of them, my eye just kept being drawn to that photo. And so that's the one that I'm going to be drawing. And really, once you see the rough sketch, first of all, this is a very rough sketch. Where'd it go? This is a very rough sketch. Don't judge me. When I do my sketches, I don't really go into great detail, only because I spend more time on the painting than on the sketches. But this is how it's basically supposed to look. And yeah, she's a butterfly. This looks nothing like her, but like I said, rough sketch. And so on in the obituary, there is a page called Jean's Wisdom. And so I decided to take the 12 wisdom inserts and write them around the jar. And she's going to be a butterfly because it's releasing her, and just like this book, releasing her. And so yeah, I'm excited for how this turns out. This intro is very long, sorry about that. But I just wanted you all to know where the inspiration for this came from and why I'm doing it. And I'm excited about this and continue to watch for more of the journey.
So I broke my palette by trying to clean it, so that's garbage. But I found a new trick because my brushes were getting stiff. I found a new thing to do. That's hot. Sorry y'all, this thing got me, like, it was really hot. Anyway, I am boiling my brushes to make sure that they're nice and thin. Not thin, but they're smoother, because by me using oils and not using brushes made for oils, they kind of got very stiff, and that hindered the fluidity of the, oh wow, I'm melting the brushes. Let me turn this heat down. The brush got melted. it hindered the fluidity of the strokes. So I am boiling them to kind of get all the paint off. And I put a little bit of Dawn soap in there because Dawn helps out with the grease. And because oils are oily, it can help clean the brushes a little bit better as well. So that's what I'm doing.
Y'all see this freeloader? There's the freeloader.
No, I'm not a freeloader, Billie Jean. You can.
That's what they have. Oh, but y'all, I did not record me doing the outline. Can you shut up? And first of all, he can sing. I don't know why he playing like that. But I did not record me doing the outline. So this is how the outline looks. And if I start, I just want to let y'all know that, so that when y'all see me painting, y'all know I already pre-did the outline.
Thank you.
Come back and let the paint dry, and in the meantime look at the length check. The shrink is just real, y'all. Needed to grow some more though, but yeah, that's my hair. And I'm probably gonna twist it up, but come back later.
It is now 8 o'clock. I took a break to do my hair, and about to start.
I'll always love my mama. She bought me in this world.
Sometimes I feel so bad when I think of all the things I used to do. How mama used to clean somebody else's house just to buy me a new pair of shoes. I never understood how mama made it through the week when she never.
Some hills to climb. I've had some weary days and some lonely nights. But when I look around, yeah, I think things over. You know what? All of my good days outweigh my bad days. I want complain. Sometimes the clouds hang low.
Okay, so I'm going to, let me not put that in the camera. I am going to come back tomorrow and actually, what time is it now? Like 12? Mm-hmm. I'm gonna come back later on today once this dry and put some more little touches on there. I may do it at 3:00 in the morning. I don't know. It just depends on how I feel. Anyway, see you soon. Hey y'all, it's currently 1:19 and I'm about to start back painting again. It's 1:19 p.m. not a.m. I actually went to bed, but let's start back. And this is my hair.
She gave, leaving by her bedside. I can still hear mama say, the people are depending on you, Shirley. Don't you let them down. I remember mama in a happy way.
So the painting is almost done. I just need to add a little bit more small details. So I'm going to let this dry and come back to see how it is when it looks dry, and then I'll know what I need to add. Because so far I feel like I made it too cluttered. And so yeah, but it's almost done and it looks pretty good so far. I think this is one of the best faces that I've ever painted. So we'll see. Okay, just got back from eating and I'm about to put on the final touches. Painting is done and I'm excited about it. I still think that I put a little bit too much, however I wanted to put all 12 of her wisdoms. I think it's 12 on there. And I didn't know that I was doing this, but I put exactly 12 butterflies, small butterflies on there. Her birthday is August 12th, and there's 12 wisdom pages, 12 words of wisdom. And of course, she's the center butterfly. So there's a total of 13 butterflies, but I didn't know that the little butterflies, I was putting 12 on there. But nevertheless, the painting is done. And let's get into this big reveal.
From lofty mountains. my Savior God, to thee.